Hello, everybody. Today I'm playing a game called The Man in the Attic. I don't know, have you heard of this game? Did you look this game up because you knew what it was, but you wanted to find out more about it? Hi, my name is Rin. If you haven't been on my channel before, I play a lot of spooky games. I play all the horror games that I can get my hands on. I always like to go into a game totally blind, not knowing what to expect, so that's the case with this game. This game I know nothing about. It's just called The Man in the Attic. That's all I know. I haven't seen any gameplay of it. So if you like spooky games and you like horror games, I play a new horror game every single week, sometimes two, sometimes three. I like to be as consistent as I can. Please feel free to subscribe if you haven't done so already. It helps a lot with the channel. And I'm really excited to see how we grow over time. We just started this in May. And the support already has been totally overwhelming and amazing, and I'm so happy. Yeah, let's jump into the game. There's this wall of text, so if you want to read it, just feel free to pause it. It said find phone, and I can hear it in this room. Oh my god, is it in the closet? Because if it's in the closet, I just know there's going to be someone in the closet. Okay. Find phone. If my dude would walk a little faster, that might help, but he's kind of just... Oh god, don't tell me my phone is in like a basement or something. What the heck? Oh, here it is! My phone is on the table! Please say I can walk faster than that the rest of the game, because if I can't, I will scream. Father, I just wanted to let you know that we arrived at home safely. Thank you for the invitation. We had a great time, and it was nice to catch up. I also feel like I have to apologize for Lily's behavior, but you know how kids are. And their imagination. She was probably very tired as well. Oh, I think maybe there's this theme of kids seeing the man in the attic. It's getting late, but I should clean up first. Clean up dining table. It's so dark. Why doesn't my guy turn on some lights? It looks clean to me. This is the cleanest house I've ever been in. I cannot see a thing. Oh, that's the dining table? That's dirty? That's what you considered? That's really cool, the noises. Today my brother came to visit and he brought his family along, his wife and their 7-year-old daughter. Her name is Lily, and technically she's my niece. It's been a while since I last seen them, so we spent about half an hour catching up with each other, just talking. After a while, I noticed that Lily was really uninterested. I don't blame her. After all, adults talking about everyday stuff is probably the most boring thing for a child. I'm a pretty good uncle, so I offered to let her watch TV in the upstairs room. Uh-oh. The attic room? Showed her all the cartoon channels and let her there to watch some TV. I left her there to watch some TV away from the boring adults. She was grateful. You can already guess what happened next. Okay, taking these dishes to the sink. Expecting a jump scare over in that direction. Oh, it's like a novel or something. The night went on. It seemed like everyone had a good time. Dinner was ready, so I was about to go upstairs to get Lily to eat with us. And that's when all of a sudden, she ran downstairs screaming and looked terrified. It took her a couple minutes before she could speak, but then she finally said this. There was a man upstairs staring at me from the doorway. Confused, perhaps a bit frightened, we all went upstairs, searched everything, checked the attic, only to find nothing. Eventually, my brother dismissed Lily's story, claiming she was probably just getting tired, and soon after they left for the night. Yeah, they were scared. I am once again completely alone in the house, and her story sounds way too familiar. Oh, we're gonna see the man in the attic. Oh god, this is the kind of thing that jump scares me the most, is when... like, shadow figures. It says go to bed. Why am I walking so slowly? Oh, he's upstairs. He's gonna be upstairs. That's the bathroom. The door's open already. That's the attic right there. If I turn around, is he gonna be in here? According to Lily's story, this is where the man was standing, looking straight at her from this doorway before returning to the attic, just like in my dreams. But were they dreams? Yeah. No, he's not there right now. The noises, they're coming from the attic? Shoot. It's already been determined that there's a man in the attic. and your house is haunted, but you refuse to leave and you're gonna go up there and face him? Why? I don't remember leaving this door open. Do you remember opening this door at all? Because I wouldn't if I lived here. Fuck. Oh, God, no. No, 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 no. Wait. Would you? Oh. Is there a literal man up here? This is stupid. There's nothing up here. What the heck is that? Why is that up here? Go back to bed. Would you go back to bed? Could you go back to bed? Could you even live in this house? You know full well that all this is going on, right? But it's not enough for you to leave. I don't know what to expect. Now it's in the kitchen, isn't it? This dude is brave. This dude is stupid brave. Like, sometimes a strange noise at night keeps you awake, then you anxiously search for the cause, but you won't find anything, and you question it once more. Is the man in the attic real? Is he about to materialize? Oh, it's zooming. It's getting closer and closer. Shoot. Oh, God. I've played enough horror games to know what's about to happen next. Mm-hmm. There's some eyeballs. Fear is subjective, but it is not uncommon to be afraid of the man in the attic or the man in the basement, perhaps the man under your bed. Thank you for playing my specific fear, the man in the attic. The developer of this game has a specific fear of a man being in his attic. I feel like this game was created based on a personal experience. And you know what? I don't doubt his personal experience because, like, I grew up in a really creepy house that was built in the 1800s, and I had a lot of creepy experiences too that would make me probably not want to live in that house ever again because it was terrifying. So that was the man in the attic. That's a short game. I didn't know if this game was gonna be 30 minutes long, 2 hours long. Didn't expect it to be like 5 minutes long, but every horror game is different. And every indie horror is like its own unique experience. Holy crap, the cat just jump scared me. I didn't get jump scared in the game, but I got jump scared by my cat. But before I go, comment below, do you have any man in the attic type scenarios that you had as a kid? Or did you experience anything supernatural, paranormal, spooky, creepy? Things that no one necessarily believed you when you were a child, but like you fully believed it yourself. I could come up with a whole bunch. If anyone wants any spooky stories, by the way, let me know and I'll do a video on it because I have a bunch. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. If you haven't subscribed, be sure to do so. And I'll be back with another video or two or three. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Bye.